Today, I'm going to show you how to install Docker apps on TrueNAS the pro way, with flexibility, control, and minimal headaches. If you spent any time with TrueNAS Scale, you know that there's more than one way to run apps. Some are easy, some are powerful, and some are just kind of confusing. Option one, the built-in app store. The built-in app store is the default option. It's clean, it's simple, and great if you want to get something running quickly. But it's also pretty limited. You only get access to a small subset of apps, and customization is minimal and sometimes not even possible. It's easy, sure, but not exactly flexible. Option two, custom apps. You can also roll your own, bring your own YAML files, and define everything yourself. Sounds great, right? But here's the catch. Once that YAML is submitted, it kind of disappears into the void somewhere in the system. And editing? Good luck. You have to dig back into this tiny config box and manually tweak it every time. Option three, dockage or portainer. Or dockage. Tools like dockage and portainer give you way more control. You could manage your YAML files, handle the full app lifecycle, and see exactly what's running. It's a big step up in flexibility, but there's still a catch. Your TrueNAS apps and your Docker containers are in separate worlds. No unified view, no native update tracking. It works, but it's not seamless, and honestly, it's just one more thing to install, maintain, and troubleshoot. So here's the approach I'm using. It's simple, clean, and gives me full control without breaking the TrueNAS experience. It's all based on standard Docker tools, compose files, .env files, and volumes, but wired in a way that still integrates with TrueNAS. To show you how it works, I've got three quick examples. A draw.io container just to show the basic setup and how simple it is, an Nginx container to demonstrate how volumes and persistent storage fit in, and finally, code server, where I'll show you how I can edit the files right in the browser. So let's walk through each one. Here's how I do it, and I want to show you how simple it is. So first, I would create a dataset for my application. I'll just call this one draw.io and create it really quick. And then I would have my dataset here. Then I'm going to go into a shell so I can create my compose file, and this will get easier. We only need to do this on the first one or so. So I'll cd into my primary dataset, and if we do an ls-l to check permissions, I can see it's owned by root, but I am actually the TrueNAS admin, so I need to take ownership of this folder. So I'll take ownership of this file as myself. After that, I'm going to go into that folder, and I'm going to create my compose file. I'm going to use nano. Then I'm going to grab my compose file, pretty simple, basic draw.io compose file. I'm going to paste it in here. I'm going to write this out and then close out. And if I do an ls, I should see that file in there. This will get much easier and we won't have to do it in the shell here in a little bit, but I'll show you. Let's go back into apps and then discover apps. I don't know why you have to discover before you unlock this YAML fly out right here, but let's do install via YAML. Now we have that YAML sitting on disk. And one cool directive you can use is include. In YAML, we can use this include directive, which is going to import all of the contents from this file on disk. And this is where we created our compose file. So it should be as simple as clicking save. It will create the custom application based on that compose file. And we can see now that it's running. We can see that we have access to the shell within there, so within the container. We have access to the logs, just like we would on any other container, and it's still all running within TrueNAS's application section. And then since I said the port is on 9080, and if we go to the port of my TrueNAS server, we can see that draw.io is running. So I love this way of doing it because now it lets me version my compose file, which is on disk, and also run the applications within the app section as if they're a custom application. Pretty cool. And I can't take credit for this. There's a forum post on the TrueNAS forums which explains this. And so I was totally inspired by that forum post where now I'm going to redo all of my applications like that. So let's talk about some of the gotchas and let's look at our second example where we need to add a volume. So let's install another application. We're going to do the same thing. I'm going to create a dataset again. Add a data set. This is called Nginx. Keep it generic. Then we'll go back into the shell. We're going to take ownership of that folder. We're going to create a compose file. So a super simple compose file. All we're doing is creating an Nginx service, saying it's going to run on port 8089, and then we're mapping a volume from the local HTML folder to the HTML folder inside of Nginx so we can serve that content out. So let's save that. So let's make our HTML folder really quick. We go into here and let's create a quick index.html. And in here, I'm just gonna paste some HTML so we can see a Hello World website. Save this, close out. Now that we have those things in place, let's create the application, install via YAML, call this Nginx. Then we'll include that Nginx compose file that we just created, click save. Then if we look at Nginx, it seems to be running. And then if we go to port 8089 on our TrueNAS system, we can see that Nginx is running and you can see my Hello World page. So you might be thinking, I don't want to do this through a terminal every time, and I'm thinking the same thing. So let's install something so we can modify these files through a web browser and make everything a lot easier. So back in TrueNAS, let's create a new data set. Let's add a data set. I'm going to call it code server. Let's save. So I added a code server data set, but you know what's going here. Let's go back into our shell. Let's take ownership of that folder. Let's create a compose file. Let's grab our compose file for code server and let's paste it into here into this compose file. Now, before we launch this, we need to change a couple of things. So first of all, we need to change this volume. So let's change this volume to say the path to the config folder is going to be in the root of this code server folder, and that will map to the inside of the container's config folder. So that's an easy one. The other thing I want to change is the ID that this runs as. And this is saying, hey, we're either going to supply a PUID in a variable if we don't fall back to 1000. Now, when we've been taking ownership, we saw that the ID is 950 and the group is 950. So I would recommend changing it to your user ID. Most likely it's going to be 950, but you can check really quick by typing ID. And that will show you both your UID and your GID. And for me, it's 950. So that will take care of that. So if you want, you can map individual data sets. That's probably the best way to go. Or you can map the root of your data set, probably not the way to go. But if you created, say, like a Docker folder and then put all of these files and folders underneath that Docker folder, that'll work too. But for this, I'm just going to map individual data sets to make it a little bit easier and just so we're not mapping everything within our data set. Okay, so these volumes that I mapped are pretty simple. We're mapping a config folder to hold our code server config. Then we're mapping our code server folder, and that's mapping to the inside of the container slash code server. Same thing for Nginx. We're mapping our Nginx folder on the inside of the container, it's Nginx, and the same for draw.io. On the inside of the container, it's draw.io. So let's save this really quick. After we save that, we do need to create that config folder really quick. So if we look in here, we only have the compose.yaml. So let's make this dir config, then check the permissions really quick. I am the owner, so we look good here. So now let's create that compose file and bring the stack up. So back in apps, same thing, discover apps, install via YAML, call it code server. Point to our compose file on disk, should be able to save. Now our application is running, and so now we should be able to access this on 8443 is where we exposed it. And here's our code server, so let's first get past these prompts. Yes, I trust the author of this. We're not gonna set up AI or anything like that. Let's get out of here. Let's actually change it to dark mode. I think I can do a power command. Dark mode, there we go. Now that it's in dark mode, let's go into file and let's go into file open folder and let's see if we could find our folders. So not in config, but we should have one called Nginx. There it is that we can get to. And if we open this folder, now we can see our files within code server. Let's make this a little bit bigger. So if you wanted to make changes, say, to the index.html and make changes to our web page, we could right here through the browser. So if I wanted to say hello universe instead of hello world, I could. Then we'll need to restart the container. This has nothing to do with TrueNAS. This is just how containers work with Docker. But it's really simple since we have all of our app lifecycle stuff right here. I can go into Nginx. I can restart that app really quickly from here. See that it's down. See that it's back up, and now I should be able to go to our Hello World, refresh, and you see it says Hello Universe. Pretty awesome. But now that we have VS Code here, we can make changes to any of our files that we've mapped to VS Code. So if I wanted this compose file and I wanted to change the port really quick, I could say 8099, save this, go back to TrueNAS Scale app, restart the app again, and we can see the app is started. But before we go there, let's look on Nginx, and you can see this app that's running, it is specifying the proper port. It's saying it's on 8099. And so if I go back to our Hello World app and refresh it on 8089, we can't get to it. But if we change the port to 8099, now we can get to it. So that's how I run Docker apps on TrueNAS Scale. It's clean, simple, and gives me the control I was looking for without giving up visibility or ease of use. I'll have full documentation and links in the description if you want to try it yourself, including the forum thread that inspired this whole idea. If you've got a different approach or run into any gotchas, let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear how others are handling Docker apps on TrueNAS Scale. And if this was helpful, consider giving it a like or subscribing or even sharing it with your friends. And finally, to the TrueNAS team, please don't break this in a future update. But if you do, replace it with something even better, because I think there's a lot of folks out there like me who still want to manage Docker Compose files, at least I think. Let me know in the comments if I'm wrong. I'm Tim. Thanks for watching.